Hi everyone. In this video, I'll talk about the basics of the setup and hold time. In general, digital logic systems require circuit that can store the state of the design or that can be used to create memory elements. Sequential logic circuits, latches, and flip-flops are used for this purpose. For a flip-flop, there are two timing requirements which are key to design a robust digital circuit: setup time and hold time. If these requirements are violated, the flip-flop state becomes unstable. Before we jump to discuss setup and hold time, let's go over a basic D flip-flop schematic and understand how it works. First, the schematic. Here, the data input port is denoted by D, the clock input by CLK, and the data output by Q. The basic building blocks of this flip-flop are inverters and transmission gates. The CLK signal passes through two inverters and generate internal signals I-clock and I-clock bar. These signals are used to control the transmission gate in the flip-flops. This flip-flop is a positive edge-triggered flip-flop, which means that the data input D is sampled as the rising edge of the clock signal. The flip-flop circuit comprises a master latch, shown here in the blue box, and a slave latch, shown here in the red box. Each latch uses three inverters and two transmission gates. The input D and the output Q are buffered here. Now, let's observe the state of the gates when clock is equal to zero. In this case, I clock is zero and I clock bar is one. In the flip-flop, the transmission gate TG1 and TG4 are on, while TG2 and TG3 are off. Since TG1 is on, the new data at input D is available in the master latch up to point N, denoted here. On the other hand, TG2 is off, which isolates the new data in the master latch from the slave latch. Further, since the TG4 is on, the old data is stored in the slave latch. For the case when clock goes from 0 to 1, I clock transitions 0 to 1, while I clock bar goes from 1 to 0. Since I clock approaches to 1 and I clock bar to 0, this will turn TG2 and TG3 to turn on while switching off TG1 and TG4. This allows to keep the new data stored in the master latch and also pass the new data at output port Q. Because TG1 is off, this isolates input D from master latch to prevent any changes at the input from affecting the stored data in the master latch. Now that we are familiar with the basic flip-flop schematic and its operations, let's talk about the timing requirements of setup and hold. First, the basic definitions. Setup time is the minimum required time duration that the input data must be stable before the active edge of the clock. Or in other words, the input D in the flip-flop must be stable before the active edge of the clock for at least setup time. Hold time is the minimum required time duration that the input data must be stable after the active edge of the clock. Or in other words, input must be stable after the active edge of the clock for at least hold time. Let's understand these definitions with the signal waveform of the D flip-flop. The input D of the flip-flop must be stable at least for time T setup before the active clock edge. Similarly, D must be stable at least for time T hold after the active clock edge. If the setup and hold requirements are not met, which is a scenario when data is not stable in the setup and hold window, the flip-flop can go into metastable state or capture an incorrect data. Let's talk why setup and hold times are required in the flip-flop. First, the setup time. When clock is zero, the new data is available up to point N in the master latch. As soon as the clock goes high, this new data will be latched in the master and also passed to the output pin Q. The time it takes for input data D to reach to node N is the setup time. It is clear that in order to capture the correct data in the master latch, it is critical that the new data at D must arrive at N and settle at a stable value before the clock goes high, switching off TG1 and switching on TG3. Therefore, D must be stable long enough to travel from the input port through three inverters and transmission gate TG1 and reach to point N before the clock goes high. If the data is sent before the defined setup time, there will be a stable value at N. However, if D arrives late and reaches only after the first inverter before TG1 is off, the new data hasn't even arrived inside the master latch and it is lost. If D arrives somewhat late and it reaches only up to after the second inverter up to point P, before the clock goes high, the node N still contains the previous value. And in this case, a data contention can happen inside the master latch. This can cause metastability in the flip-flop. If this occurs, the flip-flop may have an unpredictable time delay and can settle down to either 1 or 0. Due to this contention, the new data may be lost or not get latched in the master. Now for the hold time. The clock signal goes through inverters to generate iClock and iClock bar. So there is a time delay between clock, iClock and iClock bar. Due to this time delay, the transmission gate TG1 is not turned off immediately after the rising edge of the clock, and it takes some time to switch off. While TG1 is turning off, it is important to maintain a stable value at input D to ensure a stable value at node M, which further propagates to output. If input data D changes while TG1 is turning off, the new data can sneak up to point M or further and create contention with the previously staged data at point N. This would cause metastability in the master latch. The path highlighted here is key to find the hold requirements of a flop and establish a stable value at node M. Now for a latch. In case of a latch circuit, we do have timing requirements similar to the flops. However, these are with respect to the falling edge of the clock, if it is a high-level sensitive latch, as shown in the waveforms. Here, data D must arrive well before the T setup time and also must be stable at least for T hold time after the falling edge of the clock. So that's all for this video. In next video, I'll talk about the setup and hold constraint for static timing analysis.